Alright, time for some more Baldur's Gate 3. Alright, so this is where we left off last time. I think we were on our way to Baldur's Gate. Or rather, we were taking care of some business here. But then again, she doesn't get much benefit from a heavy armor, so... this would be better suited for her. It's not like, it's not like she has much in the way of dexterity. In the way of dawn, for Lethander cannot protect you where the light doth not reach. So what do we get out of this? Not much to see here. Nope, balsams. Give me some balsams.
Satisfies you. Let us linger no longer in this limbo of indecision, but settle on your knowledge of the individual I seek. Ever a man of measure. Would it pain you greatly to assist me along the little voyage I intend to undertake to this aforementioned camp? And I would confirm it to my thanks for your excellent guidance. Ah, and yonder I spy the object of my pursuit.
Elminster?
The very same, Gale. And a fair bit miffed he is, too, finding himself forced to expose his best pair of boots to so many miles of country road on your behalf.
I don't understand.
How so on my behalf?
I was bid and spare neither time nor my own self to find you. She sent me, Gale. You know of whom I speak.
But why? Out with it, Elminster. Please.
Young man, has your sojourn away from Waterdeep washed away your decorum as well as your patience? Nigh a 10 day I've gone without honest fare, worthy of the name, drank naught but what the sky entitled my thirst. Why, some bread, cheese, and a cup of wine would appear unto me a feast. Surely you would begrudge me a mite of rest and repast before I get out with it. And a great kindness that would be. See, Gale? Even in these barren parts, the art of hospitality begets inspired new works. If only one keeps up the practice.
Oh, Father.
Fine, fine. I'll turn a deaf ear to the clarion calls with which my scorned stomach beseeches me. Graver matters are at hand. Plenty to digest, after all. A good deal to stew over, if you will. Words ladled with import should be savored so as to better absorb their meaning. Wouldn't you agree?
Elminster!
Right. You see, that is to say, Gale, my boy, I've come to address a most pressing matter. I'll speak as plainly as I can, forswearing the accustomed frills that decorate my speech. I'm here on behalf of Mistra. The message and the charge I bring you are hers.
The long-awaited question. Now, if you please, Elminster, the too long-awaited answer.
You know where you went wrong, Gale. We needn't dwell on that here and now. But even so, to be given a chance of redemption.
Mistra would consider forgiveness.
She would consider what she considers to be forgiveness. Mistra is aware of the misadventures that have befallen you both. She knows of your strife with the absolute, that most insidious of evils. They choose the instruments of their will with great precision. Sometimes the single drops we think we are do not realize what waves we are building up to be. Do not discount yourself, and by the same token, do not discount your enemy. You must know that the absolute is more dangerous than you can possibly conceive. It threatens all who live, even those who are undying. It threatens the gods, the weave, the very fabric of the universe itself. That is why I have come here to charge you, Gale, with its destruction. It is Mistress' belief that only you.
All.
Precisely. Mistra has granted me the power to stop the clock, as it were, on the orb's rush to overpower you. Instead, you will be able to unleash its lethal combustion at will.
Interesting. This could be help or hindrance. We shall have to see.
absolute. Whatever that may be. And use yourself as the catalyst that will burn it from this world.
He is not. But it seems that Mistra is.
It brings me no pleasure saying this, my friend. But such is Mistra's will. Yours must be the sacrifice that will undo the absolute. And for your sacrifice, you will be redeemed. Such is Mistra's promise. With that, I've said my sorry piece. I need only bestow unto thee the charm I was bid. It is done. Both charge and charm have been committed into your care. To you, I commit into care Gale himself. I count on you to shepherd him well on this strangest of journeys.
On my honor, I'm not sure yet I can say the same.
Like moons make swell and wane the nescient seas, so too the sky-strewn gods ordain the tidal fates of mortal days. And yet, an ocean born in lonely hours, come ebb, come flow, come all that is beyond the breadth of our dominion. Be a moon unto yourself. Even the waves of fate can break upon the shores of will. Farewell, my friend.
Farewell, Elminster. I'm glad she chose you.
All right. So let's talk to Gale. He's got more to say. Oh, another ball.
With Elminster is never less than memorable. I'd have hoped to introduce you to him in less dire circumstances. But those are hard to come by these days. It's not a demand he wanted to make of me. His mistress chosen, he had no choice but to deliver her message. However much it pained him to do so. For Mistra to have sent him, the severity of her bidding could not be clearer. Or weigh more heavily on me. Time seems so infinite when you're young. A month is an age. A year is a lifetime. It is a strange feeling to realize how little of it one might have left. Of course, you offer the clearest solution to our problem. All I have to do is find the right place and time, close my eyes, and let go. The slate will be clean. Wrongs will be righted. The absolute will be gone. And I along with it. No doubt she has the power to do so, but as for the permission, Ao would not look kindly on her meddling in mortal affairs. Divine intervention has a tendency to make things worse, not better. As for Elminster, he saved the realms more times than legend can recount. To take on a god is no easy feat, even for him. My orb is the best chance we have. And only I can wield it. If there was, I'm sure the goddess of magic and the greatest wizard who ever lived would have identified it. But alas, only one solution is offered. That remains ahead of us for now. The heart of the Absolute must be discovered before I can stop its beating. Then I suppose there is nothing more to be done but find the heart of the Absolute and stop its beating.
will want.
Hells! Father's been taken to Moonrise! Shit, shit, shit!
That name, Gortash. I know of him. A so-called military advisor to the Baldur's Gate elite. A weapons dealer, in cruder terms.
We must rescue Father from Moonrise. He is a powerful man. The most beloved duke in Baldur's Gate.
Should the absolute cultists infect him, there's no telling the damage he might do when he's returned to the city. I think that unknowable powers come with unknowable consequences. I can't say I'm not curious, but once you've taken a lithid by the talon, there's no telling how deep into the abyss it might drag you.
Let's save it here, because we're gonna have to persuade this guy one way or another.
Say I'm not curious, but once you've taken a lithid by the talon, there's no telling how
God drag you. Really? I can only assume these are all 18 difficulties. So which means you'd have to get 18 or a critical success to persuade him.
I can't say I'm not curious. But once you've taken a lithid by the talon, there's no telling how
bingo
deep into the abyss.
Third time was the charm.
I'm more than a bit wary, I admit. Still, I am the frontier's avowed protector. New dangers require new skills to vanquish them. If the tadpole must be my curse, then let the powers it grants me be the Sword Coast's blessing. I will consume what I must to make it so.
I hate to break it to you, Will, but these elite powers are mine. Second thought, never mind. Well, anyways, let's just end the day here. Since nobody's got anything of interest to say here, I think it's time for us to, time for bed. Nice work, buddy. You deserve a treat for that.
Scratch his tongue, lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
All right, nice work, buddy. All right, let's return back to where we once were. Jay. Oh, little guy. Jesus. dead rabbit. And the Blue Jay somehow got himself inside a rock. Interesting. Shadow Cursed Lands. Hopefully this will get us to Baldur's Gate.
Something's on my mind.
Oh, was that Gale's granddad? Doesn't ring a bell. All right. Must have had something important to say to Gale if he came all this way. Good news, I hope. Whoa now, he's got a... Well, I guess that would explain a little, but... Mistra? I mean, this is a lot to take in. What's he going to do? To pick the right one. Or better yet, I'll do it. Fucking wizards, man. They always need help picking the simple, obvious option. If Mistra can't think of another way to stop the Absolute from sacrificing Gale, she's no god worth worshipping. I'll say that to Gale in, you know, gentle terms.
Actually expect Gale to just sacrifice himself like that. Seems like a waste of a fine mind. Elminster. Even the Githyanki have heard tell of the Sage of Shadowdale. Some of his works have been translated to Tissu. That doesn't mean his every word carries wisdom, however. Near as I can tell, Mistra demands Gale's faith, but holds no faith in him. Why else would she demand Gale sacrifice himself, and perhaps so many others? Does she not think he can destroy the Absolute with his own immense talents? Does she not know the mighty company that he keeps? Demanding Vlagith may be, but she acts for the good of the Githyanki people. Mistress is concerned only for herself. Perhaps he'd find forgiveness in a fiery death. But I can't help but wonder why he'd want it at all.
Not much to say there, I guess.
Supreme Kithrak, has Vlakith sent you to slay me with your own blade?
I've not come to kill you, Lazel. I've come to aid you.
Don't trust him.
Skagak Kir Gith Shabeleth. My blade rests. Mother Gith compels you to listen.
My ear is yours.
I know you carry the astral prism, Lazel. Within it lies the seed of Vlakith's demise, and I intend to help you bring it to fruition.
Vlakith's demise? Skagath! I should run you through for suggesting it.
Asking for your help. trust. I've heard word from Kresh Ulic. You are infected. Yet the one in the prism has chosen you. Protects you with their power.
The prism. How would he know this?
Alone has the power to end Vlakith's tyranny. I've sought their freedom for eons. When the prism went missing, I feared the worst. Instead, you've granted the opportunity I've so long awaited. All that remains is the key that unchains them. And I've found someone who I believe can provide it. Bring the prism to Baldur's Gate. I'll be waiting in a taproom called Sharis's Caress. That is where we decide the fate of my people. Lazel, together we will break our chains and be Vlakith's slaves no longer.
I am no slave, Shastil Kithrak. The Undying Queen is my freedom. It is she who will purify me, and she who will ascend me.
Lies, Lazel. Every last one. There is no purification, no ascension. The Zaith Isk does not purify. It extracts memory and kills the infected. Nor does the Lich Queen glorify the ascended. She feeds on most all of them to grow her power and pursue godhood.
Madness! You flood me with this heresy. I will hear no more of it.
I see Talakma Gear in you, sister in freedom. Together, we will be our people's light. Take this. It is a Quanith, a psionic detector. The Queen's warriors hunt you. The Quanith will sound you out when you come near their portals. Hear its cry, and prepare for battle, or slip away. I should go. Vlakith's gaze pierces the seas and skies. She believes me loyal, and I can't afford her mistrust. Keep the astral prism close. Let no one take it from you. Slay any who try. Now to Baldur's Gate. I'll be waiting, Lazel.
Good luck.
Purification is a fairy tale, then I have not sinned against Vlakith. She has sinned against me. Ascension is a young Githyanki's greatest honor. Long ago, the Geth enslaved my people. They dominated our minds and bred us for war, until Great Mother Gith took a hammer to our bonds. From the day of our hatching, young Gith have one purpose. to train hard enough to slay a Geth and take its head. Then, we speak the rite of ascension, and a red dragon comes to fly us to Vlakith, in Tunarath, City of Death. We are honored with an eternal home in the Astral, celebrated for our victory. We are ascended. Or so I believed. When the Kithraki come for me, and come they will, I will submit to their blades. They would feed me to their dragons, and I would deserve no better. I'd never thought Vlakith a tyrant, or me as a vassal. She was the source of my might, and I the envoy of her will. A warrior, a champion, a destroyer. To be harvested and devoured. Every Githyanki is a slave with a singular purpose. Not to cull the Geth, not to prevent their grand design, but to raise Vlakith to true godhood. I don't know. I can't know. And that drives me mad. At first, I thought them an illithid deception, a trick of the tadpole. Dream figure is real. It lives in the prism. Voss believes they are the seed of Vlakith's demise and the agent of Githyanki freedom. And I believe he may be right. Yes. I'd like time to think. We'll meet Kithrak Voss at Charess's Caress in Baldur's Gate. Until then, be vigilant. Vlakith's eyes are upon us.
And that's the end of Act 1. I guess. So now we move on to Act 2.
This place is dark beyond dark. You feel it too, right? I'm sticking to light wherever I can find it.
You have an engine in your chest. You could use that as a source of light. Or have you forgotten?
Are you the true soul? I'll take that as a yes. Listen up. Grab a torch, stay out of the dark, and move fast. Shadows have eyes. Go on.
Well, lucky for me, I do have a torch, so... No, not yet.
With haste.
Thank you.
shadow curse. It doesn't seem to affect me like it does others. Not as badly, at least. Do you know what this means? I must be blessed. Lady Shah is protecting me where others are left to face her wrath. She loves me. She must do. Lady Shah wouldn't bless me like this for no reason. There must be something she wants of me. Those signs we found about Dark Justicius, perhaps they were no coincidence. In either case, I need to watch for any place dedicated to Lady Shah. A temple, perhaps.
Most interesting. Tankling's journal charting the journey from Elturel to the Emerald Enclave and now on the road to Baldur's Gate. The axe just up and died. It started choking out of nowhere, then keeled over. We tried to pull the cart, but the axe knocked the wheel off when it went down, and the thing is in splinters. The others want to grab what we can and keep going. This place feels wrong. My skin is wrong, like something is watching us from the darkness. No one else is talking much, but I can tell they feel the same. An old map in a druidic style of what appears to be hidden routes out of the Emerald Enclave. The destination is marked as Baldur's Gate, and a note is attached. Take only what you can carry. Go through the mountain paths. If anyone falls, leave them. You can't afford to be slowed down by excess baggage. Good luck. Thank you. going the wrong way. Find out what these cultists are up to.
Hey, boy. Want a bone? Fetch! You see that blight echo? Swallowed the whole by the shadow curse. Bet it was pure tasty. You're the true soul we're taking to Moonrise, I'm guessing. Aye, in the shallows. But the curse don't care about some itty-bitty light once you get deeper. Don't worry, boss. We've got a guide. Talk to Kansif inside. He'll run through it. Wait, you're joking, yeah? But we're ready to go. You just need to tell Kansif inside. So you want me to... I'll just go and,
More to this than meets the eye, so to speak. I don't think we're quite ready to go just yet, because we got other things to take care of. Excluding the fact that we gotta go to Moonrise Towers. There's gotta be more to this place than here we go. Thank you. beat Charles Shadowrun Sack, huh? So I wonder what kind of potions and elixirs we'll be able to make out of this. Store here. No, I want to see what's on the boy's mind. Because there's always something far more sinister than just a simple game of hide and seek. Success.
Not an ordinary child.
Not an ordinary child, but not a specter either. One part of a greater whole, something ancient and oddly sad.
Something ancient and oddly sad.
I don't know what you mean. I'm just me. I have a mummy, a daddy, a pet doggy. They don't need names. They just need to be mummy and daddy and do what I want. Now play with me, or they'll be angry with you.
The boy doesn't like these questions.
The boy doesn't like these questions because he has no real answers and perhaps no real family.
I don't know what you mean. The shadows must be making your head go funny. I'm not going anywhere. I like it here. Play with me or else. All right. I'll hide, and you seek. Find me, and you win. Get ready, and no cheating.
I know he went this way.
Something good here, I hope.
What do we have here? Wow. That's a level 9. Shadow Curse is a powerful threat that lurks and devours in the darkness. Surround yourself with light to avoid most lethal effects. Wow. Those guys do not play nice. Jesus, this is not a good sight, man. But I'm seeing it a little bit more clearly now. I guess it's up to these two, now. Thank you. you. Oh, wow. Fate must wait. So lucky for me, I still have my torch. But where's Lizelle? Where is she? She's right over here. Where is she? Oh, she's underneath all of that. Can you get her up?
Time to waste.
Oh, there she is. She's underneath there. Friend back so we can continue. Oh, but she's buried underneath all this dead mass. There we go. Oof. Wow. That was... Like I said, that was probably the most intense battle we've ever had. Oof. We're ending the day here. Now what?
Playtime's over.
This time of year, the dickheads start popping up wherever you look.
What do you want, Mizora?
Drop the attitude and perk up your ears. You've got a new mission. Absolute's cult has gone and grabbed one of Zariel's assets. A devil, and a powerful one at that. They're locked up in the cult's fortress, Moonrise Towers, and you're getting them out. Clause set, section 13. Should promised soul refuse obeyance or neglect duty, the pact holder shall cast the promised into Avernus as a lemur. I'll make
interesting
it
word.
Simple. Will fails or refuses, and he turns to a thick blob of stink flesh and sinks to Avernus. Now, be a good boy and play fetch, pup. Or you'll spend an eternity sizzling in the hells.
Mizora's words may be flippant, but they are
tinged with desperation. She cannot afford for Will to fail this mission. I'm sorry, what was our first clue again? This may be your best chance to negotiate Will out of this pact.
Oh, and what condition is that?
Your mind link with Will is drawn in by his increasing panic. Will relaxes and your connection fades.
Interesting. Now, why should I go letting my favorite pet off his leash?
Let's try option number one.
Interesting. Now, why should I go letting my favorite pet off his leash? Winning hand. Fine. I'll play your game. But I amend the pact once the mission's done, not before. Clause F, Section 9. Soulbinder shall bestow reward or favor only upon Soulbearer's fulfillment of related obligation. Now, to Moonrise, pet. And do mind the shadows. They've been especially hungry.
Damn it! Why did it have to be Mizora? Why did it have to be Zariel? We're supposed to risk our necks to get one of her assets. What if it's a runaway like me? Or something far worse? I never forget what Will did. Not ever. I'm here because of him. And I'd do just about anything to help him. But devils never lose. You know that, right? Sure, they'll give you a bit of tat here and there. But the house always wins.
Let me ask what Will has to say about this.
The more bullshit she pours, the more of it I'm forced to swallow.
Mizora set me on fiends inside and outside the Hells. She's never ordered a rescue.
Gods. She makes a mockery of everything the Blade stands for. Such an asshole.
The same thought crossed my mind. I'm only to hunt the Infernal, the Demonic, and the Heartless. But nowhere was it stated that I can't help one. Either we find it, or I'm made a mindless blob clawing at demons on the front line of the Blood War. And it means everything to me. I always knew what my future held, and I know I chose right. Thank you for sticking your neck out for me. I mean it. But I'm not going to celebrate till I'm actually free. I can feel Mizora scheming, plotting. She won't let me go without making a fuss. Trust me on that.
This is interesting. What does he have to say?
This dark land must be filled with the broken, the beaten, the desperate. The perfect praying ground for a devil who offers a way out for those who sigh on the dotted line. I hope we end up seeing our friend Raphael down here somewhere. Help me find him, and you'll find out. When I was taken to his house, I was caught off guard. But now I know what to ask for. All in due time. But not now. I'm sure he'll turn up at one point or another.
Not like we've got much of a choice. After that crazy battle we had, yeah, we need more than just a full rest. And another dream sequence.
The voice of the Absolute is strong here. I'm getting stronger. I don't know how much longer I can resist it. But it's good to see you're making progress. You took an unexpected route here. You did a brave thing, saving those people in the grove. Don't be so hard on yourself. It's not your fault the world is wicked. You did the right thing.
The hurt runs deeper than she's willing to show you.
The voice of the Absolute. Stronger this time.
Beneath the resilient veneer, a touch of fragility. She needs comfort.
She needs comfort.
Aw, how nice. How weird, actually, now that I think about it.
It's been a very long time since someone did that. For me. Of course. It just doesn't stop. We are being bombarded by waves of telepathic energy. Wave after wave with hardly a breath between them. I almost dare not rest. Each wave a set of orders to the infected. The order for your transformation has been given many times already. There is no doubt. Moonrise Towers. I just hope my powers last long enough to see this through. In any case, the Absolute knows you carry me with you now. It wants to retrieve me. I am the only one who can resist the Absolute's influence. Hence its fear of me. Unfortunately, that also means it is dedicating more and more resources to my retrieval. The task ahead is monumental, but we're all that stands between victory for the Absolute and freedom for all. This is not just about you and I anymore. It has become far bigger than us. You must infiltrate Moonrise Towers, discover the secrets of the Absolute, and put an end to it, so we can finally be free. Now I must rest, and you must carry on. Do not let my efforts be in vain.
Well, anyways, let's head back. Actually, now that I think about it, to be fair, everyone should be carrying torches. Well, actually, I'll just still take the lead. Ooh, I'll take some more Olander, though. Fool me to think I'd fare better than the other treasure hunters in this God's cursed wasteland, but the promise of a cursed beast as a trophy was a temptation I couldn't leave behind. Bloody Needle Blights took me by surprise, though I'm not sure how. How could I have expected anything less? It's all so much worse than I imagined. Found a key up here, but unless it lacks a chest full of water and sunlight, I have no use for it. Interesting. Very interesting, to say the least. Oh, you got a new feat available, huh? Well, let's take a look here. Let's do skilled here. Let's see here. That's one. Ooh, definitely gotta do medicine for sure. Yeah, let's do these. I think our spells look good. So let's just move on. Got a new fee for her. Get her skilled too. I think we're gonna stick with the tiger. Yeah, I definitely want that for sure, because she's already got the tiger, so I might as well stick with it. Definitely gotta save, of course. Not going through all that again. We gotta disengage.
Damn, it's good to be alive.
Run towards the light. Alright, my turn. Alright, everyone to me. Let's go. We're out of here. Alright, who's stuck? God, I swear. Alright, now that piece of malarkey finished, let's continue. Light in south Wreathwind Town. What did that say?
North, last light in. South, Wreathwind Town.
Oh, more Black Olander. Very nice. Wait a minute. Wait. Surprise. I thought it was that kid that we were looking for. Nope, but it wasn't.
This is gonna feel good.
Wow, who would have thought a torch could do it, could actually do that? Oh, he bleeding good. was a perception check. I didn't really think a torch could be that damaging. But I guess you get to do with one has, I suppose. Speaking of which. Let's continue. Wait. Let's just finish him off. Bunch of ceramics. Interesting. Can I reach up? Can I jump up there? The answer is yes, I can. Cool. Cool. Well, it's not gonna be enough room for everyone. Here. Luminous gloves, huh? Okay, that has to be a quest item. Moon Maiden, protect those of us who will not turn from you, no matter the consequences in this short life. Keep these artifacts of our devotion until such a time that we may openly infuse our spirits with your white light once more. Grant cunning to my brother, Halfred, in his efforts to conceal the rest of your relics. Let the name last night not be a portent. Let your moon glow continue forever and fill our hearts. A resistance? Okay, so we're gonna have to go to Last Light Inn. Let's see what's going on with all this. Now, where are those? Here they are. Is there anything else of use here? That's Moonrise Towers. Okay, the last light ends over there. This trap. Ah, it's right there. Yeah. All right, trap is disarmed. Very nice. Interrogation transcript. Let's read this. Official interrogation transcript. Harper in charge. Caledove Everspring. Transcriber Luna Shorn. CE. Your name? Dahl. Dahl Timber, ma'am. Occupation? Farmer, ma'am. Potatoes. A farmer? How many guards has Throm stationed at the South Wall, Dahl Timber? What do you mean, South Wall? Do not play the fool with me, Timber. The Moonrise South Wall. I don't know, I swear. Liar. Write this down, Luna. Throm's spy refuses to cooperate. Harsher measures required. I said write it down. Ring of Twilight. Interesting, to say the least. Well, I'm not going to go to Moonrise Towers yet, because from what I heard, it's really, really hard. So we're going to have to play the waiting game just a little while longer. Still have to go to Last Light Inn, though. Thank you. Internal log of True Soul Corliss, Day 4. Scouting mission dispatched by Kethric Throm to Shadowlands. Objective, locate nest of absolute non-believers. Reach outskirts of village, disturbing sounds echo throughout the shadows. Must evade pursuit. Preparing to create a light barrier for protection against luring monsters and deadly darkness. May the absolute guide me. Oh, this is where I wish I had a speak to the dead scroll. Oh, that would have been real handy right about now. I have a feeling he may have a lot to say. Now, hopefully once we get to Baldur's Gate, maybe we'll come across a store that sells scrolls. If so, I'm so getting one, and I'm coming back here for sure.
Find allies here, or at least supplies.
We'll see. No shadows here. Something must be keeping it at bay.
You there! Step forward and keep your hands off your weapons. Who are you?
Just keep your hands where I can see them and follow me.
Jahira!
This is why we're here, you see. It is a curious creature that hides all manner of secrets. But if there's one thing that we know... it's that it knows its own kind. You should never have come here, true soul. Interested in the Absolute's manipulations. Harpers, cut this true soul down!
Stop! What are you doing? He's the one who saved us!
He's the one who protected the Emerald Grove.
Yep. Didn't leave a goblin standing. Not so bad to hang around with either. Saved one of my friends from a druid with a snake. Knows when to be discreet, too. Pretty much trust him with my life.
A true soul with a mind of his own?
How is that possible?
Hmm.
the hells is that thing?
Congratulations. You've earned yourself the benefit of the doubt. Hear me, Harpers. All clear. At ease. I'll not pretend to understand what that artifact is. But I'm old and wise enough to recognize a sliver of hope when it crawls out of the dark. Tell me, why have you come here? Then you found an ally in me. For that is precisely why I am here. There's food in the inn over there. Beds too, if you require rest. Aloe oil in the cupboard, in case the vines gave you a rash. Settle in. Then come join me for a drink. You may just be the godsend we've been praying for.
Wait. I wonder what she wants.
Oh my god, soldier. That's Jahira. The Jahira. Don't you know the whole story? Years ago, over a century, Jahira was part of a group that saved Baldur's Gate from Saravok, a Baalspawn trying to plunge the city into war. My mum used to tell us stories about them. The legends who protected the city from evil. She said Jahira was a powerful druid. Adamant. Tough. I've told myself those stories 1,000 times since. I never thought I'd meet Jahira. She's a hero, and I was always some outer city kid. Can't believe she wants to talk to us about working together. What a day!
Damn, it's the person we gotta talk to, huh?
Uh-huh. Thought I sensed an infernal. What are you doing here?
Same thing as you, I reckon. Trying to stay out of the shadows. Hold on! I know you! The weaponsmith, right? Drafted into the Blood War when your city was swallowed by Avernus. Not too different from my own story. Well done making it out alive.
Same to you. Though unless my senses deceive me, you brought a bit of the Hells back with you. Infernal engine?
Who needs a heart when you've got one of these to keep you warm? Thank you, Zariel.
Forget warm. You're burning up. Might be burning out a piston ring. Or leaking oil. Mind if I take a listen?
Please do. I've been dying to find an infernal mechanic.
Now that's hot. Too hot. I think I could sort you out. But I need some infernal iron and a lot of.
Hey, soldier, we've got some infernal iron already. Let's give it to him, eh?
Yes! Yes, we should! I feel like I'm about to blow in more ways than one. Ashore!
Please let this work.
The weight of it. Blaze of chaos. Can't imagine this where my heart should be. Must be quite the experience. Give me just a moment.
Oh.
call it, I'm afraid. I don't think there are thick enough gloves in all the realms to protect from that kind of heat.
That feels... good. I'm still burning hot as hell's hole, but I feel less... changeable. Cheers, mate.
Pleasure. And as for the heat, I haven't got any solutions now, but I'm not giving up. Could be if the combustion chamber had its own insulation, or if we had some kind of enchanted coolant. Let me sleep on it. I just might be able to work something out. Hopefully the next time I see you, I'll have something promising to report. I'll need more infernal iron either way, though, so keep your eyes open. Take care.
Upgrade didn't cool me down, but it did juice me up. I don't think I've ever felt more powerful. Sooner rather than later would be good. I feel like I'm burning serious fuel. Oh, fuck yes. I'm ready to burn all night. Speaking of, I could eat a giant badger. Is it almost time for dinner?
Now, where is that kid who stood up for me? I gotta speak to him. Before I go to the last, inn. I gotta find him. What are you looking at? Is there something of interest? Oh yes, let's talk to her.
Please. Be welcome. Have a drink.
Oh my God.
To your very good health.
You know, I think this is going to be a good place to stop for right now. All right. That's going to do it for the session here. And thank you to those who watched. I will see you all next time.